morning. Now we'll be seeing the blood components. If you are taking 1 cubic ml of blood, there will be 55% of plasma, 45% of blood cells. So we discussed about plasma and now we will discuss about blood cells. Blood cells, RBC, WBC and platelets. These are the major concepts. So now we'll see about RBC. RBC, red blood cells. RBC. Why we are calling RBC as erythrocytes? What is the reason behind it? See, our kidneys produces one hormone called as erythropoietin that leads to the process of formation of RBC called as erythropoiesis. This is a nothing but formation of RBC by the process erythropoiesis. The formation of RBC occurred, that is the reason we are calling it as erythrocytes. Okay, in 1 ml of blood, how many of the RBC will be present? There will be 4 to 5 million of in 1 cubic ml. In 1 cubic of ml of blood, there will be 4 to 5 million of RBC. What is the major function of RBC? RBC carries oxygen. This main function is about carrying oxygen. Why it is a good carrier? Good carrier of oxygen. Why? Because by nature, by the structure of RBC is not having, it is not having nucleus and it is not having mitochondria. That is the reason it can able to fill maximum of oxygen into it. That is the reason it's a very good carrier of oxygen. Who will be responsible for the transportation of oxygen? Hb, hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is responsible for the carrying oxygen, transportation of oxygen. The main oxygen carrier is hemoglobin, which will present in our red blood cells. How it forms? Hemoglobin, how it forms? It's a formation of hemo plus globin. See what it means. Heme is a ferrous and globin is a protein. Ferrous means it's an iron. See, it will be with the 4 iron molecules plus 1 protein form like one circle, like one constructed circle with the four iron contents and one protein. So this leads to formation of one circle. It is very helpful for the carrying of oxygen. That is the reason. Okay. Then how we will be calculating our Hb? Hb is very important. Why? Because for a human, for a healthy human, there will be a minimum or a maximum. I'll tell you the normal levels of Hb first. The normal levels of Hb for the healthy survival, for males it should be 14 to 18 mg per dl and for females it is about 12 to 16 mg per dl. In children it is 11 to 13 mg per dl. This is the normal level of our hemoglobin. If the this much of content in our blood is this much of content in our blood Hb is present, means there will be healthy the person will be so healthy. Okay, how will be counting the Hb? with a complete blood count. In 100 ml of blood, there will be 12 to 15 grams of hemoglobin, which is very important for the carrying of oxygen. Okay. Abnormal increase or abnormal decrease of normal level of RBC in our blood means the normal level is in 1 cubic ml 4 to 5 millions RBC. It is a normal level. Abnormal increase or abnormal decrease of RBC. Abnormal increase of RBC, it is called as polycythemia. This is a disease condition. Abnormal decrease of RBC, it is a condition erythropenia. These are the disease conditions. Okay. Where will be RBC will be forming? RBC will form in the embryo. For embryo, the formation of RBC will occur in liver and spleen. For an adults, where the RBC will be forming? For adults, the formation of RBC will occur in bone marrow. In the very long bones, in that bone marrow, the formation of RBC will occur. Okay. Our hemoglobin should be, when we are inhaling oxygen, our hemoglobin binds with oxygen and it can form as, it will be forming as oxyhemoglobin. In another situation, rare situation, if the person is working in mines or in any smoke industry, they may inhale that carbon monoxide. So that time this oxygen and that carbon monoxide will they both want to occupy the hemoglobin. Then what is going to happen means this carbon monoxide plus Hb will form like carboxyhemoglobin. This condition may lead to death also. This is about our RBC. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos.